The personal income tax is the largest single source of money for the federal government. The law requires that the bulk of the tax owed by an individual be paid as the income is earned. For this reason, employers must deduct money from the gross earnings of almost every employee. These deductions, called income tax withholdings, are sent periodically to the Internal Revenue Service. The amount of money withheld from each employee depends on several factors, including marital status, gross earnings, and the number of withholding allowances and income. Generally, the withholding tax for a married person is less than the withholding tax for a single person making the same income. Each employee must file a W-4 form as shown with his or her employer. On this form, the employee states the number of withholding allowances being claimed, along with additional information so that the employer can withhold the proper amount for income tax. For example, if we have a person that's married with three children, they could claim a total of five allowances, one for themselves and their spouse, along with the three children. This then would be used to determine the amount of tax obligation, and being married, they'd be at a lower tax rate. Plus, because of having to provide for three children, they would be taxed at a lower amount. Gross earnings are the basis for the tax amount being held, and generally a person with a higher gross earnings is going to have more withheld for taxes. There are two methods used to determine the amount of tax. One is the wage bracket method, and the other is the percentage method. And we'll take a look at both of these methods, starting with the wage bracket method. The Internal Revenue Service supplies withholding tax tables to be used with the wage bracket method. These tables are extensive, covering weekly, biweekly, semi-monthly, monthly, and daily pay periods. There are different tables based on marital status as well. And in the textbook, we have pages as well as the pages available electronically in Math Excel showing what these would look like. Here's an example. This is a page from the tax table for persons that are single and they are receiving monthly pay. This line that's highlighted is showing the number of withholding allowances being claimed, and you might think someone single would only have either one or no allowances, but if they are in a, say, head of household where they're actually responsible for minors or individuals that they can claim as dependents, they could have these numbers for their allowances. The left-hand side is indicating the wages, and it's a bracket method where we're looking at least for the first column and a less than for the second column. So we would find the range or interval that fits the earnings for the individual and then match it up with the number of withholdings to determine how much money will be deducted from their pay and sent to the IRS for their federal income tax withholding. This is another example from the tax table, but it's showing the withholding amount for someone that's married and receiving pay on a weekly basis. We still have the number of withholding allowances, and here's the intervals for the wage. So you would find the range that fit the amount of their wages, and then read the appropriate amount of withholding for federal income tax based on their number of allowances. Let's take a look at this example here. Bob Martinez has monthly earnings of almost $2,900. He's married and claims four withholding allowances. Find his withholding tax using the wage bracket method. We would need to find the appropriate page using the tax table. We would want to identify the number of withholdings, and in this case it would be four. And actually you can see this in the textbook on page 243. We'd want to make sure we were using the married table as well, looking for the interval that contains his monthly earnings. And here we have at least $2,800, but less than $2,840. We would line it up with the number of allowances, and according to the table, and of course we would be looking at the married one, is $29. So $29 would be deducted from his gross pay, and his employer would send that off for his income tax or federal withholding tax obligation. There are states that require income tax as well, but some states do not have income tax, and here we have a list of the seven states that do not. In addition, there are states that have a limited income tax. They are Tennessee and New Hampshire that only tax income from dividend and interest. There are some states having a flat tax rate or a percent of income, but the majority of the states issue tax tables with taxes going as high as 9% and 10%. We have an example of an optometrist here. Assistant working in Michigan has a gross earnings of $3,225 for the month. Determine the state withholding tax. And we would be supplied this information, or here in the textbook, looking for Michigan, we could determine what that tax rate is. It's a 4.35% income tax. Multiplying that by her wages would give us the amount of tax that would be withheld from her gross wages and sent off to the Michigan Department of Revenue. In these next slides, we're going to take a look at calculating our federal withholding using the percentage method. We had the tax table method, and here's the percentage method. The advantages of using the percentage method is that you don't need this half-inch thick book of tables. And because of the procedure for using the percentage method, it lends itself to creating a program to determine the amount of withholding. It's based on a specific amount for each withholding based on the pay period or the frequency an individual receives their pay. For example, we have a gross pay of $2,000 biweekly. They're married with two allowances. We have two allowances for a frequency of biweekly. So we'll take the $140 from the table, 38 cents, multiply it by two, and this is the allowance. So this is what their gross pay is reduced by for the amount that is excluded from taxes. So here is their taxable income. The next step then is this formula followed in the percentage method. Because this individual's married, we would go to the portion of the percentage method that gave us the tax rate based on marital status, and in this case it's married, and it says, if the amount of wages after subtracting withholding allowance is not over $606, there's no tax withholding. Well, it's over $1,700. So we read until we find the range that captures this net pay, and it's the second line here. It's over $940, but not over $2,910. Above this next part, it says the amount of income tax to withhold is $33.40 plus 15% of the excess over that flat beginning minimum of $940. So we know they're going to be paying the $33.40, but we need to do a calculation of 15% of the excess over that minimum amount in this interval. So we take their net taxable income minus 940 and multiply that by 15%. So the minimum tax is $33.40 plus 15% times the difference for the excess amount. If you simplify that, the federal withholding income tax for this individual would be $150.29. Here we have our table again showing the withholding allowance based on the frequency of the payroll. And this can be found in your textbook. The second part of this is based on the tables depending on the frequency of the pay, weekly, bi-weekly. There would be one for semi-monthly and monthly. And on the left-hand side is for individuals single marital status and those that are in married marital status. From there, we would then read to determine the amount of withholding based on the amount of income that the individual had. Let's look at another example. Sadie Sims is married and claims 3 withholding allowances. Use the percentage method to find her withholding tax in a week where her earnings were $1,263. It starts by determining the amount of withholding allowances. She's paid weekly and she has 3 withholdings. So we'll take the $70.19 for each withholding, having paid at a weekly frequency, times it by 3, the number she is claiming, which means we will subtract that from her gross wage. The amount in blue then is the amount of her wages that she will calculate the tax obligation for federal withholding. Next, we go to our percentage method table. We need to find the one that deals with weekly, and we're interested in the married person portion of it. We're looking for the range that captures her taxable income. And if you look, it's the second line here. It's over $470, but not over $1,455. It's within that range. If we read further, it means that she's going to be paying $16.70 plus 15% of the excess over, we kind of have to jump up and read the heading, over her taxable earnings less the $470, which has already been taken care of with this $16.70. So here's what the formula looks like. With order of operations, you'll want to find that difference between the beginning amount for this interval and the taxable. Multiply that by 15% next, 0.15, and then add it to the beginning amount of income tax that will be withheld. Totaling that, this individual will have $104.06 withdrawn from their gross wages and sent off for their tax obligation for that year to the federal government. In this example, Howard Martin has earnings of $5,735 for the month. He is married, claims 4 withholding allowances, use the percentage method to find his withholdings. So we're going to look at his frequency of the pay period, which is monthly. The withholding amount is $304.17. We times that by the 4 withholdings. This is the amount of allowance, so we subtract that from his gross wages. That gives us the taxable earnings that we in turn go to our tax table for the percentage method. We're looking for married. We find the interval that captures his taxable earnings. It's here where the arrow is indicating. And just like the last one, it is a flat $72.50 plus 15% of the difference of this amount. Doing that calculation, simplifying, He has a tax withholding